What's up, everybody? Welcome back. I'm back here at the wood yard today, and I am on the hunt for wood that will season and dry quickly. There's a lot of it back there. You can see all this stuff that I have pulled out of the pile already. It is really faded from the sun. The bark's fallen off. I think some of it was dead when the tree was cut down originally. So this stuff is all pretty much dry already. And that's what I'm looking for. It just takes a while to dig it out and hunt it up.
What's up, Gary?
You get all this wood from me.
Try it. I brought a cover for the log splitter.
Yeah?
I got one.
Check it out.
Brand new. I didn't even get the cheap one. It's a medium duty. But for this winter, man, I think it'll be good when it gets snow and ice and everything on it.
Yeah, I'm thinking about buying a shed and putting a wood splitter or something
around here.
Shed for the
car. Bring the shed here. Okay. Well, I bought that.
I got this.
Yeah, I'll put it on when I'm done. Or if you want, I was gonna use it today. If you don't mind. Over there, I'm gonna split this stuff and then the rest of that cherry over there.
Oh, you cut it up then?
Some of it I have to.
I'm trying to clear this road out so I can get in here.
When I get done with like this busy firewood season, I'll start taking some of this stuff. There's a bunch of cedar. I burn cedar, but a lot of people all ask for hardwoods, and it's like, I don't mind having cedar, but people don't want to buy it.
If we sell a lot this winter, I would. If I don't have tree work, I would. But if I got tree work, I ain't fucking
with it. You'll sell wood straight out of here?
I sell wood every winter, and I ain't got nothing to do. Last winter, it wasn't that hot. I mean, cold, really.
Yeah.
But I sold some.
Do you have some somewhere else that's seasoned, or do you just take it out of here?
I just take it out of here. Yeah. Out of there.
All right.
I wish I can get my splitter away after there. There's a lot of hickory to get back there, man.
Yeah.
Man, a whole bunch of hickory, like three truckloads. When the guy bulldozed it all back, he got it all in the bottom, probably.
That's what I was saying over here. Like, there's a bunch of slash and wood chips and crap. It's all on top. I'm like, I wish these weren't buried in that, because that holds water. You know what I mean? It stays wet under all that wood chips.
Probably a lot of rotten wood under there.
I think the bulldozer did it right over here. But you ever get shag bark hickory or?
That's what I know. Well, I got pig nut over there.
I know it's hard to tell the difference between that
shag bark. Shaggy bark.
Yeah, that's pig easy to tell. Smooth. Big nut looks on. I mean, you can tell that's elm, but I mean, it just has a little bit of a X pattern in the picker. It's hard to tell. You can tell.
Yeah.
I have a hard time telling.
You might bring a saw over and cut some of them big ones up. People can get back in here and get some of that. Get big one right there. Put it through there and cut up. Man.
Yeah. Okay, enough talking for now. It's time to get back to work. I gotta buck up these rounds and get them ready for the splitter. This next log right here is a classic example of one that's about 26 inches long, and I hate to cut off ends and waste because all of this wood needs to be removed from this wood yard. So I don't like leaving waste behind. I just cut it right in half and it's good enough. So you heard me say right there, I hate to waste all this. That's what I was looking at. If I would have cut a cookie or an off cut off the end of that, it would have been about 6 inches. And anyways, I haven't really had any complaints from people that the wood is too short. I mean, I think they get more concerned if it's too large. But it just makes nice little pieces of firewood. They're just kind of on the short side a little bit. But this wood yard is completely packed full of wood, and you can't really see off the right side of the screen, but that you can see the gates open right there. There's wood piled up all the way to that gate. I mean, you have to basically climb into it just to get in the gate. You have to step over wood and walk on top of wood to get back in there. And all of that seasoned wood that I'm cutting is on the other side of the yard. I mean, if you can imagine, when they started dumping, they started dumping at the back and filled it up from back to front. So all the seasoned stuff is at the back, and you got to walk in over top of all this stuff and carry it out. It takes a long time, and you got to be careful. It's kind of dangerous to be walking on all that stuff, and it's just a lot of work getting it out of there. But you know, I enjoy doing it and everything, so I can go spend a couple hours digging through it all and looking for good wood. Especially right now that I need wood that's going to hurry up in season and dry fast, or that is basically already dry. You heard me tell Gary that as soon as I'm done with selling firewood, if it slows down at all, I'll be able to just start loading more stuff. I mean, once I can just start cutting whatever, anything. I mean, I can get oak, I can get beech, whatever, and it'll have all year to season next year. Then I don't have to walk as far. I can just grab whatever looks good right there by the entrance, and that'll save a lot of time. Right here, I'm just looking at the pile. They just dumped a fresh load, and that's oak, and I missed the action of them dumping the truck, which I'm not happy about. But you can see that cherry back there, and it is awesome cherry, and there's more oak. And it's back to splitting elm. This log splitter does really well splitting elm. It is stringy, and I mean, it labors through some of it, but it pushes through it. And I've been burning elm for a number of years, and I didn't even really realize what it was until fairly recently. But I've been splitting it by hand a lot of times. And I use my electric splitter a little bit too. I was finding a lot of dead standing elm trees around my house and burning those over the past 5 or 10 years. And I assume it's probably because of Dutch elm disease. I mean, none of them are very large trees. They're all 6 to 8 inch diameter, you know, little trees that are already passed away, and the bark's fallen off of them and they're dry. And I split a lot of it by hand, but it's been one of my favorite woods. When I need wood and I gotta go out hunting it up myself, I have enjoyed burning elm, because when I cut it, it's pretty much dry already. There's no bark on it. It burns nice and smooth. It doesn't pop and snap and crackle and shoot stuff all over your carpet and everything. It's just a nice smooth burning wood, and it has a nice flame, and it burns down to a very, you know, a fine ash, and that's it. So I mean, it's not a bad firewood. I wouldn't want to smoke with it in your smoker or anything, but as far as a firewood, I don't mind it at all. And also, because elm is so stringy, and you can see how it's splitting and leaving all those stringy strands behind, it just ignites really well. All of those strands act like a kindling, and it gets it burning and gets the flame going immediately, and before you know it, the whole log's on fire and it burns. So it's pretty good in my book for a firewood. So now I'm finished splitting all of that dry elm, and it's time to just load my truck, and I'm going to stack it in rows because I want to fit some more cherry in here with this while I'm here. So that's going to be up next. I'm going to get some of that really nice cherry and put a load of that in my truck. And I have just been throwing all kinds of wood in my nice little truck, but it is a work truck. I just don't want to tear it up too bad. So I might need to start being careful. A little more careful about throwing wood into the back, you know, with reckless abandon. One thing about having the hard tonneau lid is, though, you can't break a back window, although you can only load about a rick, maybe a little more. This is the load I got. A little bit of fresh cut green wet cherry. And the rest of that in the back is mostly seasoned elm. A little bit of seasoned maple. But that stuff's all real dry. You could see when I was splitting it, it's all barkless. It's faded gray from being in the sun, sitting out. It's dry stuff. It's testing at 15%, 17%. Already, so it'll be real dry within a couple weeks.